Well, as we near Valentine's Day, a love story nearly lost forever. It was more than 15 years ago when a graphic designer from White Bear Lake came upon World War II era letters at an antique shop in Stillwater. The result of that find is Marcel's Letters, a book. And the graphic designer that found those letters, Carolyn Porter, joins us now to tell us more. They have not given me enough time to talk to you about this fascinating story. So the point is, you were shopping, you found these beautiful letters. Why do we say you're a graphic designer? Because the reason you bought the letters was because of the handwriting.
Right, and I wanted to find letters that I could use as the basis for a font. And Marcel just had beautiful handwriting. And as I was standing in the store, I knew immediately I was going to use his handwriting for the basis of a font.
Now, 15 years later, it's a book that you have written
because
of the content of those letters.
Right, which I had no idea of in the store. The letters were written in French. I don't speak French, and at the time it didn't matter. But I had one letter translated, and it turned the journey in a completely different direction.
These were love letters that Marcel had written to his family, right?
Right, to his wife and his three young daughters. And they were back home in France. He was in a labor camp in Berlin, and these letters just include the best and the worst of humanity.
Everything that he experienced while he was there.
Right, everything he could write about.
Right.
But beautiful words of love for his wife, telling her, for example, he sends her a kiss every night, and words of advice for his young daughters, but also explanations of what life was like inside the camp.
So what made you decide that you were going to turn these letters into a book?
Eventually, I became obsessed with finding out what happened to him, And eventually, the whole story, it was bigger than me, bigger than the font, bigger than him. It was just a story that needed to be told.
And so we won't give away how the story ends, because that's obviously part of the book. But what do you want readers to know about this journey that you're taking them on?
Anybody is capable of uncovering a story from history that needs to be rescued.
And you said you've inspired many people, and the story's inspired many people, to go up into their own attics and just look for things that maybe grandparents or great-grandparents may have written.
Right. I've heard that from a number of readers, that they've read old letters from parents, grandparents, and they've gotten to know grandparents and parents as they were when they were young.
And it's hard to believe sometimes when you see those people as elderly in your life, you don't think of them as being young and in love and maybe sharing the same experiences that we do.
Right, and very personal letters, you're able to express emotions that you maybe wouldn't otherwise.
I have so many questions that I'm not allowed to ask you. So, but you have plenty of events coming up that you want people to know about.
I do, and on Wednesday I'm going to be at the Hamlin Library in St. Paul, and I'll actually be reading from some of his letters.
And will you answer questions if people have them? You know, like a lady in the back who raises her hand.
Maybe.
Carolyn, thank you so very much.
Thank you.
A fascinating story.
Thank you.
And again, she has a number of book events in the Twin Cities, Hamlin Library on Wednesday. But if you want to find out more, go to our website, carolevin.com, and you can find out all the information right there. Carolyn, thank you so very much.
Thank you.
All right. We'll be right back.